Welcome dear students for standard 9th algebra chapter 5 linear equations in two variables lecture 4. Let's recall what we have learned in the previous modules. We have learned to solve simultaneous equations in two variables using two methods, that is equating the coefficients and substitution method. We have also learned to solve the word problems. Now, we will recall once again how to solve the word problems. Read the given word problem carefully and try to understand it. From the given information, use proper variables for given quantities. Form the mathematical statements with above variables. Use a suitable method to solve the equations. Find the solution of problem and verify your result. We have to write the answer in full sentence. Word problems of various types. We will be dealing with the word problems regarding age and numbers based on fractions, money transactions, geometrical properties, speed, distance, and time. Let us start solving the word problem of problem set 5, question number 5. A two-digit number is 3 more than 4 times the sum of its digits. If 18 is added to this number, the sum is equal to the number obtained by interchanging the digits. Find the number. Let the digit in tens place be x and that in the units place be y. So our two digit number is 10x plus y. From the first condition, 10x plus y is equal to 4 times the sum of the digits, that is 4 multiplied by x plus y plus 3. So therefore 10x plus y is equal to 4x plus 4y plus 3. Now taking 4x and 4y to the left side, we get 10x plus y minus 4x minus 4y is equal to 3. We get 10x minus 4x is equal to 6x. And 1y minus 4y is equal to minus 3y is equal to 3 on the right side. Dividing the equation by 3, we get 2x minus y is equal to 1. That is equation number 1. The number obtained by interchanging the digits is 10y plus x. Now, x was in the units place. That will be in the tens place. And y was in the tens place will come to the units place. So, from the second condition, 10x plus y plus 18 is equal to 10y plus x. Taking 10y plus x to the left side, we get 10x minus 1x is 9x and 1 minus 10y becomes minus 9y. Is equal to minus 18 on the right side. Dividing by 9 throughout, we get x minus y is equal to minus 2, that is equation number 2. Now, subtracting equation number 2 from equation 1, we get 2x minus y is equal to 1 and x minus y is equal to minus 2. Changing the signs, x will become minus and minus y will become plus y. Minus 2 will become plus 2. So minus y and plus y will get cancelled. 2x minus 1x is equal to x and 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. So x is equal to 3. Substituting x is equal to 3 in equation 2, 3 minus y is equal to minus 2. So minus 3 will be taken to the right side, we get minus y is equal to minus 2 minus 3 minus y is equal to minus 5. Cancelling minus sign from both sides, y is equal to 5. So we get x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 5. Substituting the value in the two digit number, 10x plus y is equal to 10 multiplied by 3 plus 5. So 30 plus 5 is 35 is our required number. Question number 6. Total cost of 8 books and 5 pens is rupees 420 and the total cost of 5 books and 8 pens is rupees 321. Find the cost of 1 book and 2 pens. Let the cost of 1 book be rupees x and the cost of 1 pen be rupees 5. According to the first condition, the cost of 8 books and 5 pens is rupees 420. Therefore, 8x plus 5y is equal to 420. That will be our equation 1. Now, according to the second condition, the total cost of 5 books and 8 pens is rupees 321. So we get 5x plus 8y is equal to 321. That is equation number 2. Now, when we see these two equations, the coefficient of x is 8, which is as the coefficient of y in the second equation, and coefficient of y, that is 5, is the coefficient of x in the second equation. That is, the coefficients are interchanged. When we get such type of questions, we will directly add equation 1 and 2. So we get 8 plus 5 as 13x plus 5 plus 8, 13y is equal to 420 plus 321 is equal to 741. Dividing by 13, we get x plus y is equal to 57. That will, we will take it as equation number 3. Now we will subtract equation 2 from equation 1. Then we get 8 minus 5 as 3x and 5 minus 8 as minus 3y is equal to 321 subtracted from 420 will be 99. We will divide that equation by 3 to simplify it. We get x minus y is equal to 33. So that is equation number 4. Now we will be solving equation 3 and 4. Add it, we get both the y variable will be cancelled. So 2x will be equal to 90. Therefore, x is equal to 45. Substituting x is equal to 45 in equation number 3, we get 45 plus y is equal to 57. Therefore, y is equal to 57 minus 45 and that will be equal to 12. So, cost of 1 pen will be rupees 12 and cost of 1 book is 45 rupees. So, cost of 1 book and 2 pens is equal to x plus 2 into y. So, that will be equal to 45 plus 2 multiplied by 12. So, 2 multiplied by 12 will be 24. Plus 45 is equal to 69. So the cost of 1 book and 2 pens is rupees 69. Now question number 7. The ratio of incomes of 2 persons is 9 is to 7. The ratio of their expenses is 4 is to 3. Every person saves rupees 200. Find the income of each. So, solution, let the income of first person be rupees x and that of the second person be rupees y. According to the first condition, the ratio of their incomes is 9 is to 7. So, income of the two people are x upon x and y. So, we will write x upon y is equal to 9 upon 7. So cross multiplying we get 7x is equal to 9y. So 7x minus 9y is equal to 0. So that is equation number 1. Now each person is saving rupees 200. So that is saving income minus saving will be the expense. So expense of the first person will be x minus 200. And expense of the second person will be y minus 200. So according to the second condition, the ratio of their expenses is 4 is to 3. So we get the expenses as x minus 200 upon y minus 200 is equal to 4 upon 3. When we cross multiply, we get 3 multiplied by x minus 200 is equal to 4 multiplied by y minus 200. So that is equal to 3x minus 600 is equal to 4y minus 800. Now taking 600 to the right side and 4y to the left side, we get 3x minus 4y is equal to minus 800 plus 600. And that is equal to minus 200. So we get 3x minus 4y that is equal to minus 200. We will take it as equation number 2. Now multiplying equation 1 by 4 and we get 28x minus 36y is equal to 0. So take it as equation number 3. And multiplying equation 2 by 9 we get 27x minus 36y is equal to minus 1800. So solving equation 3 and 4 we get 28x minus 36y is equal to 0 and 27x minus 36y is equal to minus 1800. So minus 36 and plus 36 will get cancelled. 28x minus 27x will be 1x. And right side we are getting it as equal to 1800. So the value of x is 1800. Now substituting x is equal to 1800 in equation number 1, 7x minus 9y is equal to 0. Therefore 7 multiplied by 1800 minus 9y is equal to 0. So 9y is equal to 7 multiplied by 1800. Now, therefore, y is equal to 7 multiplied by 1800 upon 9. So, y is equal to cancelling 9 and 1800, we get 200. 7 multiplied by 200, therefore, y will be equal to 1400. So, the income of the first person is 1800 rupees and that of the second person is rupees 1400. Now question number 8, if the length of a rectangle is reduced by 5 units and its breadth is increased by 3 units, then the area of the rectangle is reduced by 9 square units. If the length is reduced by 3 units and breadth is increased by 2 units, then area of the rectangle will increase by 67 square units. Then find the length and breadth of the rectangle. Solution: let the length of the rectangle be x units and breadth of the rectangle, that is original rectangle, be y units. So area of the original rectangle r is equal to xy square units. Length of rectangle is reduced by 5 units. So we get the length of the new rectangle R1 is equal to x minus 5 and breadth of the rectangle is increased by 3 units. Therefore, breadth of the new rectangle R1 is y plus 3. Now, area of the new rectangle R1 is reduced by 9 square units. So, area of the rectangle R1 is xy minus 9. Now, area of the new rectangle, that is R1, is length into breadth. So we will multiply x minus 5 into x y plus 3 on the left side, and that is equal to xy minus 9. When we open the brackets, we get x multiplied by y is xy, x multiplied by 3 will be plus 3x, minus 5 multiplied by y will minus 5y, and minus 5 multiplied by 3 will be minus 15, and that is equal to xy minus 9. So xy will be cancelled from both the sides. We get 3x minus 5y is equal to minus 9 plus 15, and that is equal to plus 6. So our first equation is 3x minus 5y is equal to 6. Now length of the rectangle is reduced by 3 units. So according to the second condition, the length of the rectangle 2, that is R2, is x minus 3, and breadth of the rectangle is increased by 2 units. Therefore, breadth will be is equal to y plus 2. Now, area of the rectangle is increased by 67 square units. So, what will be the area of the rectangle R2 is equal to xy plus 67. Now, according to the second condition, area of the new rectangle R2 is length into breadth. So, we multiply x minus 3 multiplied to y plus 2 is equal to xy plus 67. So, when we open the brackets, we get x multiplied by y is xy, x multiplied by 2 plus 2x, minus 3 multiplied by y is minus 3y, and minus 3 multiplied by 2 is minus 6. On the right side, we get xy plus 67. So, both the xy from both sides will be cancelled. We get 2x minus 3y is equal to 67 plus 6. So, that is equal to 2x minus 3y is equal to 73, equation number 2. Solving for equation 1 and 2, we get 3x minus 5y is equal to 6, and 2x minus 3y is equal to 73. So, multiplying equation 1 by 3, and we get 9x minus 15y is equal to 18. And multiplying equation 2 by 5, we get 10x minus 15y is equal to 365. Now, subtracting equation 3 from 4, we get 10x minus 15y is equal to 365, and 9x minus 15y is equal to 18. So when we are subtracting, the sign of the second equation will be changed. 9x will become minus 9x, minus 15y will become plus 15y, and 18 will become minus. So minus 15y and plus 15y will be cancelled. So we are left with 10x minus 9x, that is 1x, and equal to left hand side we are getting 347. So x value of x is 347. Now this we will substitute in equation number 2. So therefore 2x, that is 2 multiplied by 347 minus 3y is equal to 73. So we get 2 multiplied by 347 as 694 minus 73, we take it to the left side, and minus 3y will be taken to the right side. So it becomes positive. So 694 minus 73 will be 621 is equal to 3y. Dividing by 3, we get y is equal to 621 upon 3, and that is equal to 207. So the value of x is 347 and value of y is 207. So the length and breadth of the rectangle are 347 units and 207 units respectively. Question number 9. The distance between two places A and B on a road is 70 kilometers. A car starts from A and another starts from B. If they travel in the same direction, they will meet in 7 hours. If they travel towards each other, they will meet in 1 hour. Then find their speeds. So, solution students, We will start as speed of the car starting from A be x kilometer per hour, and that starting from B let it be y kilometer per hour. Now speed of the car starting from A will be more than the speed of the car starting from B, then only they will meet after 7 hours. So x greater than y. According to the first condition, the distance covered by first car in 7 hours will be equal to 7x kilometer. Using the formula, speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is equal to speed into time. So time is 7 hours and speed is x. So distance covered by the first car in 7 hours is equal to 7x kilometer. Similarly, distance covered by second car in 7 hours is equal to 7y kilometers. So the distance between A and B is 70 kilometers. Therefore, the distance covered by car from A is 7x kilometer, and distance covered by car from B point is 7y kilometers. So the distance between, since the distance between A and B is 70 kilometers, therefore 7x minus 7y will be equal to 70 kilometers. So the first condition is 7x minus 7y is equal to 70. Dividing by 7 from both sides, we get x minus y is equal to 10. So that will be our equation number 1. Now, according to the second condition, the car is traveling in opposite direction. That is, the car from A is going to the right side and car from B is going to the left side. So in 1 hour, the car from A covered x kilometer, and in 1 hour, the car from B has completed y kilometer. So they are meeting in between 70 kilometer. So x kilometer completed by A and y kilometer completed by B will be total equal to 70 kilometer. So according to the second condition, x plus y is equal to 70. Now taking equation number 1 and 2, we will add it. So x minus y is equal to 10 and x plus y is equal to 70. Minus y and plus y will be cancelled. So 2x is equal to 10 plus 70, that is equal to 80. So x is equal to 80 upon 2. Therefore x is equal to 40. Substituting x is equal to 40 in any of the equation, here we are taking equation number 2, that is x plus y is equal to 70. So our equation becomes 40 plus y is equal to 70. So y is equal to 70 minus 40 is equal to 30. So the speed of the car starting from place A is 40 kilometer per hour, and the speed of the car from B is 30 kilometer per hour. Question number 10. The sum of a two-digit number and the number obtained by interchanging its digits is 99. Find the number. Now solution. Let the digit in units place be x and digit in tens place be y. According to the given condition, the sum of a two-digit number and the number obtained by interchanging its digits is 99. Now, our original number will be y is in the tens place and x in the units place. Therefore, the number is 10y plus x. And the number when interchanged, it will be x in the tens place and y in the units place will be 10x plus y. So according to the condition, 10y plus x plus 10x plus y is equal to 99. So 10y plus 1y will become 11y and 1x plus 10x will be 11x. So that is equal to 99. Now here in this question we have only one condition. Therefore dividing by 11 we get x plus y is equal to 1. So if we are taking y is equal to 1, we get x is equal to 8. So therefore the number will be 18. If we take y is equal to 2, then x will be equal to 9 minus 2, that is equal to 7. So our number will become 27. Similarly, if y is equal to 3, then x will be 9 minus 3 is equal to 6. So the number will become 36. So we have the two digit numbers as 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, 63 and 72. So this is till 8, from 18 to 72. So here we have completed problem set 5 with all the statement questions and all the questions involving simultaneous equations. Thank you, students.